Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on how to solve first order linear or a homogeneous recurrence relation with example problem. Okay, in the previous video, how to solve the first order linear or a recurrence relation and what is the general solution of first order linear recurrence relation, that can be discussed in the previous video. Now in this video, how we are solving the first order linear recurrence relation with one example problem. Okay, so the given problem is solve the recurrence relation a suffix n plus 1 is equal to 4 into a suffix n for n greater than or equal to 0, given that a naught is equal to 3. Okay, so the given recurrence relation is a suffix n plus 1 is equal to 4 into a suffix n. By observing this recurrence relation, so what is the order of the recurrence relation? It is a first order recurrence relation, because here this is the n plus 1th term. Okay, for n plus 1th term, what is the previous term? Previous term is a suffix n. Okay, n plus 1 term, previous term is n term. Okay, so n plus 1th term can be defined in terms of only one previous term, that is a suffix n, with one initial condition. Okay, then it can be called as a first order linear recurrence relation. Okay, so therefore the given recurrence relation, is first order linear or a homogeneous. Okay, how can you say that this recurrence relation is a homogeneous or a non-homogeneous? Here f of n part is equal to 0. If f of n part is equal to 0, then it is called as a homogeneous recurrence relation or a linear recurrence relation. Otherwise, it is called as a non-homogeneous recurrence relation. But here, f of n is equal to 0. So hence, we can say that it is a first order linear or a homogeneous recurrence relation. So whenever the given recurrence relation is a first order linear or a homogeneous recurrence relation, the general solution of first order linear or a homogeneous recurrence relation is a suffix n is equal to c power n into a naught. Okay, this is the general solution of the first order linear recurrence relation. It is equation 2. Okay, now if a suffix n is equal to c power n, suppose a suffix n is equal to c power n, here this is the initial condition. Okay, there is no worry about it. If a suffix n is equal to c power n, then then a suffix n plus 1 is equal to c power n plus 1. That means in the place of n, we are substituting n plus 1. A suffix n is replaced with a suffix n plus 1 is equal to c power n is replaced with c power n plus 1. So that is n is replaced with n plus 1. N is replaced with n plus 1. Okay. Now, so here, what is the value of a suffix n plus 1? Already given that this is 4 into a suffix n. Okay, from the given problem, a suffix n plus 1 value is 4 into a suffix n. Okay, next c power n plus 1 can be written as c power n into c. We are already know that. Okay, so that means a power x plus y can be written as a power x into a power y. Okay, in the same way, c power n plus 1 can be written as c power n into c. Okay, next one, 4 into a suffix n value is nothing but c power n value. So c power n is equal to c power n into c. So here a suffix n is equal to c power n. Okay, so both sides c power n is there. So we have to cancel c power n on both sides. So therefore 4 is equal to c. So therefore c value is equal to 4. Okay, now c value is substituted. C value is substituted in equation 2. What is equation 2? This is the general solution of the first order linear recurrence relation. So therefore a suffix n is equal to c value is 4, 4 power n into a naught. Okay, what is a naught value? In the problem, a naught value is given as 3. So it can be a power n into 4 power n into 3. Okay, sorry, a power n is equal to 4 power n into 3. Okay, so this is the general solution. This is the solution of the given recurrence relation. A power n is equal to 4 power n into 3. 4 power n into 3. So this is the solution of the first order linear recurrence relation. Okay, so thank you. Only c value we have to find out. C value is 4. C value can be found by using this one. If a suffix n is equal to c power n, then a suffix n plus 1 is equal to c power n plus 1. N can be replaced with n plus 1 by using the substitution method. So a suffix n plus 1 is equal to c power n plus 1. So a suffix n plus 1 value we are given 4 into a naught. A suffix n is equal to, it can be replaced with by using this formula c power n into c. Okay. So 4 into a suffix n can be replaced with the c power n. So c power is equal to c power n into c. Both sides c power n is cancelled. So then c value is equal to 4. This c value can be substituted in the general solution of the first order linear recurrence relation. So that is a suffix n is equal to 4 power n into a naught. Okay, a naught value is already there in the problem, that is a 3. So substitute a naught value is equal to 3. So here a naught is equal to 3. Okay, so this value is substituted in this place. So a suffix n is equal to 4 power n into 3. Okay, so this is the solution of the given recurrence relation. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel name. So Divvela Srinivasa Rao. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and classmates. So thank you.